Entrepreneurs get stuck. They want to host an event, but they can't picture how they alone could hold a stage for a whole day, much less three. Actually, it's more simple than it looks. And inside today's episode, I have three hacks to help you see the possibilities for your next event. Inquiring minds want to know, how are entrepreneurs like us daring bravely to build a stage, ditch the sweatpants, and step up to the mic? How do we create our own transformative events so we can get our message out into the world in a bigger way that's not only profitable, but it's actually something we can be proud of? That's the question, and the answers are inside this podcast. My name is Sarah Pfeiffer. Welcome to Green Room Central. Hey, it's Sarah. I have an invitation for you right now. You can join entrepreneurs from across the globe who share a passion for hosting their own events. Become part of the community that inspires and cheers you on over at greenroomcentral.com. A lot of people struggle. They're business owners. They're super successful. They have courses. They have a membership. They teach all the time, but they get really hung up when they go to want to host an event, especially like a multi-day event. And I think the hang-up typically gets in the space of, gosh, what would I teach? How would I fill all that time? And then they kind of spiral into this place where they want to bring on all of their friends as guest presenters. And it becomes this just big, like talk fest. And no one's going to any level of depth because they don't have time. And that's no fun for your guests. They really want depth and they want it with you because you're the person who speaks the way that they hear, and you're the one who teaches the way that they need to learn. And so I want to really help you get over that hump of how would I fill the time? What would an agenda look like? And these are hacks. This is going to get you there fast if that's what you're looking for. And I've got three of them for you today, and we're going to move really fast through them so that you can get into action. All right. So pick one of these, like listen to all of them and then think about like, hey, does this one feel like this might be the right fit for me? Not each of them aren't going to be a fit for everyone. So hack number one is the post-it note hack. And I call this like a brainstorming trick, really. I love to just grab a stack of post-it notes and a Sharpie marker and a blank wall and stand up with a timer and just like write on the post-it notes and stick them on the wall in any order. In fact, no order is best at this time. And when your timer goes off, maybe you give yourself 10 minutes. Then you stand in front of the wall and you kind of arrange them in the order that it feels like it makes the most sense to teach them. Does that make sense? So you really can get to a place pretty quickly where you're able to fill the time. And then you just kind of like assign some times to each of those and kind of feel if, figure out how much time you've gotten in a day and kind of look at all those post-its that have time stamps on them. And, you block in your breaks and your lunch and you're ready to rock and roll. So that's hack number one. That's the post-it note hack. All right. So the second hack that I have for you is the name each day of the event hack. So this hack really is about creating a mini framework, and people love frameworks. They love them because they help them organize their thoughts and help them it helps them understand where you're going within the event and where they're at and in that kind of framework. And so where they know kind of a little bit about what's next and how far they're going to go. And it really helps for organizing, like in note-taking, and people just love to have a sense of like place and perspective, and a framework accomplishes that. So let's say you have a 3-day event, and For example, maybe I'll use Live Event Academy as an example. Day one would be Picture It, day two would be Plan It, and day three would be Produce It. Those are the three highest levels of the framework that we use within Live Event Academy, which is the world-class event framework. And then there's kind of like subtopics under each of those buckets, if you will. But then we kind of have a name for each of those days. And I bet that you have a framework already in your business. And could you go to kind of like the top level of that framework and name each day? And then that would help kind of with your brainstorming in terms of like, what would fall on that day one? What would fall on that day two? What makes sense then on day three? So that's my hack number two, which is the name the day of the event hack. Hey, I don't want you to miss out. Did you know that this conversation always continues inside the Linchpin Nation community? It's a free, modern discussion forum exclusively for Green Room Central listeners that will have a profound impact on the way you look at events in your business. Get answers to your biggest questions, hear behind-the-scenes nuggets from event leaders, and get access to helpful templates, guides, and checklists as you start and scale events in your business. Be part of the daily discussion with entrepreneurs just like you. You can join for free over at greenroomcentral.com. I'll see you inside. Let's move on to hack number three. So I call this the course hack. And sometimes it's just easiest if you take your flagship course and you turn it into a live event. And hold up before you say, wait, Sarah, I sell that thing for a premium price. I don't want to just give it all away in an event setting. And I will tell you straight away, you will not be giving away all of your trade secrets if you choose to teach your event as if it's like your course. So hold on, have an open mind for this one. So the course hack, you would take one of your courses and then you would make each block on the agenda one of the modules from your course. And so again, 3-day event. In this scenario, what I'd love for you to do is like start with placing in the breaks and the lunches, and when you know you want to stop for the day, if there's any other kind of like blocks for your offer, and so kind of like mark off all of the time that isn't available. And then you'll probably find that you've got these nice little chunks of like an hour here, an hour and a half here. And then you just kind of like number them, circle, kind of like put a box around them and put a number in each one. And I bet you will get pretty close to the number of modules in your flagship course. And then what you'll do is you'll teach the exact same way that you would have in your course, except you're doing this live. And because it's live, you're going to teach a whole lot less. And of course, you're not going to be giving out all of the tools and the checklists and the guides and all of the deep dive stuff that kinds of goes around it. You're going to be teaching at that very highest level because you need time in there to be asking rhetorical questions of the audience, to be asking, hey, are you tracking with me? Do you have this? Like, I want you to be writing these three things and down in your notebook right now. You're going to be wanting to leave time for them to, you know, like turn to your neighbor and tell me like, what was your biggest takeaway? Or what do you need help with? Let's get into a small group and take 15 minutes and each person share what they've learned, what they need help with. And so all of that takes up time. And I think you can see here how if you used that course framework to plan out your event agenda, you will not be giving away all of your material, your best material for free. But it becomes this really amazing live experience, live embodiment of your flagship course. So I hope that helps you. I hope that those three hacks at least got the juices flowing for how you could, as the expert, as the thought leader, like hold space on a stage for more than just, you know, an hour long webinar. You have it inside of you to spend a day, a full 2 days, a full 3 or 4 days on stage with no other guest speakers, just you. I promise you that you have it in you. And I hope that these three hacks that I gave you for brainstorming what an agenda could look like for a multi-day event scenario like that, I hope these three hacks helped you like have a little peek into what that could look like for you and got you a little bit more excited about putting an event like that on your calendar to host for your community, because gosh knows they would love to see you putting something out there to gather them together live, because they want to learn new content from you. They want to gather in community with you, and they want to feel more connected to you. And this is going to be the way to make that happen. Thank you for listening to the Green Room Central podcast. If you loved this episode, then please take a screenshot on your phone and post it to Instagram, and be sure to tag at Sarah Fafer and let me know why you liked it and what you'd like to hear or who you'd like to hear from in the future. That'll help me know what to create for you. Also, I've been hearing a lot of business owners say people are tired of virtual events, and that's just not true, which is why I created a brand new 5-day challenge called the Virtual Event Lab. I want to show you how to make your next virtual event profitable, engaging, and most importantly, how to make it happen. And the best part is this 5-day challenge is absolutely free. To register right now, simply visit greenroomcentral.com and we can get started today. In case you're curious, this podcast is built on Kajabi. I'm loving how easy it's been to get things set up, but more so, I'm thrilled that my entire business is run within one platform. From my emails to pages to courses, and now to my podcast, it's all under one roof. If you love simplicity and scalability as much as I do, then go to greenroomcentral.com to get a free 14-day trial from Kajabi. I appreciate your commitment to leveling up and learning the mindset and strategy of live events. Keep going, keep learning. If you want more, head over to greenroomcentral.com for show notes and all the links from today's episode.